The Deep Loyalty is a really interesting piece from Valance for this spring-summer 2021 season, especially in the Vapor color. You can see I've just pushed it together a bit just to show that this 13 denier material is really very thin, very light. It is not a winter shell after all. It is a fall or spring piece, a piece for warmer temperatures. It feels a bit see-through when I have the light shining through it even. And like I said, it's an interesting piece now in this color because of the color blocking with the black zippers that we have here. It's a Gore-Tex Zenit, three-layer Gore-Tex Zenit backer. This is very comfortable, even just with the short sleeve shirt underneath. I have gone for the M size in this, which is slightly long, but very nice. Here I find the M to be rather better, since this is something where you want to be able to do at least a bit of layering. Of course, we have this asymmetric sidewinder zip here, which is the specialty that this has. It is made not like the mainline sidewinder jacket. There's nothing to keep the collar smaller. So if you zip it open, it just is asymmetric again. So in wind, it could flap around. But of course, in wind, you want it zipped up anyways. And most Valance jackets are made to be worn zipped up. So that should not be much of an issue. The cuffs are pretty interesting. They are asymmetric, longer across the back of the hand again, and with an elastic bit almost all around inside. This could become an issue if you wear something underneath which has a cuff as well, but the way it is, most of the time with not much underneath, it is very nice. Just as I was saying that the Deploy LT might have cuffs which make it a little bit difficult to wear them with shirts and with the watches I usually have, the PR agency for G-Shock in Germany asked me if I wanted to perhaps have a look at one of the G-Shock watches new in the Skeleton series. The Skeleton series has taken some of the classic G-Shock designs and put them into transparent black or transparent white cases and of course fitting bands like that. And one of the models which they gave this treatment has been the GA2100, the watch which became known somewhat jokingly as the Kazi Oak. And well, it is worth actually a look at it. Does combine very nicely with the Deploy LT. So in another video I'm going to give this a bit of a look for, yeah, what different thing it shows about G-Shock watches and what they can be like. The pockets are simple but good. Two pockets in front I just mentioned, so I should also mention the usual two pockets inside are also here. The smaller wallet pocket on the left and passport pocket on the right. It's very comfortable, it drapes nicely. It has a look which goes more towards a bit of streetwear like Adidas Terrex, even their trail running line, but also their city line has used something like this of a pure white even color, probably undyed for sustainability reasons as well, quite a bit. That's nice. What we should have a look at with this is how it works to layer it a little bit. I'm still of the opinion that this should be taken as a warm weather rain shell, so there should not be too much underneath it, but after all, for some protection and for some more flexibility to extend the use one gets from it, we should try it out. Yeah, there is some more adjustment in the hem. We can close that down. There's the hood. The hood is relatively low volume. It's quite high and not very much going in front. There are adjustments for it as well, with inside tabs and pushers there, so one can easily snug it down a bit. And yeah, for driving rain it's not going to be ideal probably, but for just some normal rain in the summer, and maybe if you have a hat anyways or something, I mean, rain could always fall into your eyes as well. It's nice, it's a good look I think, and it's gonna work. Gore-Tex 3 layer certainly is a good thing, and this is 13 Denier, is really thin, very light, so a good travel piece as well. My Rab Phantom pull-on is just 7 Denier in a stretch Pertex shield, so that is even less, but yeah, also very light, and this in comparison, yeah, is really light. You must not mistake that for a winter Gore-Tex shell. It feels almost non-existent, really silky, very comfortable, but very light, as it's supposed to be. If I look at the deploy with the Hedden LT Blazer, for example, I'm still staying in the frame shirt I have underneath. There you can tell that this does go together a bit strangely with the two cuffs underneath, but it's, well, here it folds a bit actually. So it does become a bit strange even just with that, but it works very nicely. One can tell in the length that, as happens so often, the blazers are cut a bit longer than many of the jackets. If you wanted it completely covered, you would actually need to take a coat as the outer layer, and that must not necessarily be something for the summer. Even the wool of the Hedden Blazer LT is a performance wool with some DWR, and this might not get washed so often that the DWR would be disappearing really quickly, so it should be okay on its own anyways, and so I would trust that this would be quite okay even if a little bit of the blazer is exposed more to the elements than everything else of it. Actually, with a combination like that in the summer, the main concern would have to be how hot it gets, how much use wet, and make stuff underneath wet yourself. Yeah, this could be an issue even with this 3-layer Zenith-backed Gore-Tex, which should be a very nicely breathable one. I can't offer you a Mion, for example, for an insulating, for a mid-layer shell, but I can offer my Atom LT, which is getting destroyed a bit, but is kind of similar with a bit of insulation. So, you can have a look at there. It also has its own cuffs with some elastic. Well, I'd say slipping in it feels like this is getting a bit more problematic maybe, but actually, well, now it starts to feel like my insulated field jacket, so there is a bit more, I feel bulkier, let's just put it like this, but it works pretty well. There are no issues, at least for me, of anything binding, getting into the, what's it called, armpit. It's quite fine. It's just going to be too warm pretty soon, probably. Yeah, although now I have to point out again that this Deploy LT jacket is an M, and yeah, that seems appropriate. The Spear LT hoodie, I went for S, I went down a bit there. For the Hedden Blazer LT, for example, I also went for M, that seemed appropriate, and here it definitely is good to size up a bit, even if you don't want to layer it like that.